A pretty nice day for a visit to the zoo, the Gladys Porter Zoo. Would be a nice day to go out there, see all the animals. But if you don't, can't have a chance today to do that, we're bringing the zoo to you right now. Alejandra Rodriguez from the Gladys Porter Zoo joins us now. Hey, Alejandra.
Hi, how are you?
Doing real good. How about you?
Doing really well.
You have a slinky friend with you today from the reptilian
yes.
family, no doubt. What do you
yes,
have
Yes, so this is Leche. She is a Sinaloan milk snake. There you go. You can see her little face there.
Wow.
She's a little shy today.
So how old is she?
She's definitely over than 13. We don't have an exact date on her, or at least not that I know of right now, but I know she's definitely over 13 years old.
Wow.
So she is actually, if you've noticed, she looks very similar to a Mexican milk snake that we've also had here on Zoo Guest of the Week.
Mm-hmm.
But if you see these red bands, are fairly, really, really thick right here,
mm-hmm.
Between the other black bands and the yellow band. And she also looks a lot like a coral snake.
Yeah, I was
so
gonna
she
say.
Does use she uses mimicry.
What's a rule of thumb for people in identifying, you know, a milk snake again with a coral snake? You can go through that.
Yeah, so if you notice on Leche here, the red and the yellow bands do not touch. They would in a coral snake, and a coral snake is venomous. They're typically not going to just strike at you. So if you leave if you see any snake with red and yellow, and you're, a lot of people probably aren't going to look that close to try to figure it out.
Yeah.
If you'd leave it alone, just step away. They're probably not going to do anything to you unless they're scared.
Yeah.
If you just leave them alone, they're fine.
Is that a variety of snake that you would find here in the valley?
So the Sinaloan you will find in northern Mexico, as the name suggests, in parts of Sinaloa.
Mm-hmm.
But you will find the Mexican milk snake and the coral milk snake here in this area.
Okay. So is there an animal that you would not handle, Alejandra? You're pretty brave.
If it was a venomous snake, I would not.
Good rule of thumb there. Yeah. Very good. Zoo hours, anything special going on?
So we will be having our Kids Appreciation Day coming up in a couple weeks. So mark your calendars for that. We will be having a pickup component on August 5th. And then we'll be having a virtual event on August 7th. And this was sponsored by HEB Helping Here.
Terrific. Alejandra and Leche, thank you so much for joining us today. Y'all have a safe weekend.
Thanks for having us. You too.